Dear Esther, I have now driven the stretch of the M5 between Exeter and Bristol over 21 times. But although I have all the reports and all the witnesses, and have cross-referenced them within a millimetre using my ordnance survey maps, I simply cannot find the location. You'd think there would be marks to serve as some evidence. It's somewhere between the turn-off for Sanford and the welcome brake services. But although I can always see it in my rearview mirror, I have as yet been unable to pull ashore.
I don't know what he's talking about, but okay. I'm guessing an M5. I'm guessing an M5 is a boat. Nothing's gonna jump out and mighty me, is it? Monster could be interesting. Actually, no. That sounds very scary. And as y'all know, I suck with scary. Hello there, Mr. Boxio. I swear to God. Wait, where does this go? Now let's explore the rest of the wreckage over here.
There must be a hole in the bottom of the boat. How else could new hermits have arrived?
New hermits? What? Wait, what? Eat nor drink. And neither did he eat or drink. What? Wait, is the hermit like some sort of god that when you arrived here, you just pissed him off and he just cursed everybody? Is that it? I have a feeling I'm going the wrong direction.
I had kidney stones and you visited me in the hospital. After the operation, when I was still half submerged in anesthetic, your outline and your speech both blurred. Now my stones have grown into an island and made their escape, and you have been rendered opaque by the car of a drunk.
Away from the sea and towards the center. It is a straight line to the summit, where the evening begins to coil around the aerial and squeeze the signals into early silence. The Bothy squats against the mount to avoid the gaze of the aerial. I too will creep under the island like an animal and approach it from the northern shore.
What happens if I would have gone the other way? They don't really have time to do that, but...
The Bothy was constructed originally in the early 1700s. By then, shepherding had formalized into a career. The first habitual shepherd was a man called Jacobson from a lineage of migratory Scandinavians. He was not considered a man of breeding by the mainlanders. He came here every summer whilst building the Bothy, hoping eventually that becoming a man of property would secure him a wife and a lineage. Donnelly records that it did not work. He caught some disease from his malcontented goats and died 2 years after completing it. No one to carve white lines into the cliff for him either.
Well, What is going on here? Ah! Man. Glad I fixed my microphone. Jeez. Hope you guys are enjoying the music. Not sure if you can hear me over that, but...
House built of stone, built by a long dead shepherd. Contents: my camp bed, a stove, a table, chairs, my clothes, my books. The caves that score out the belly of this island, leaving it famished. My limbs and belly famished. This skin, these organs, this failing eyesight. When the battery runs out in my torch, I will descend into the caves and follow only the phosphorescence home. Jacobson's ribcage, they told Donnelly, was deformed, the result of some birth defect or perhaps a traumatic injury as a child. Brittle and overblown it was, and desperately light. Perhaps it was this that finally did for him, unable to contain the shattering of his heart. In half-light, his skeleton a discarded prop, a false and calcified seabird.
I'm intrigued, but I'm also not following along. As well-read as I like to think I am, I'm not. Man, still want to know what was on the other side of that. The other way.
They found Jacobson in early spring. The thaw had only just come. Even though he'd been dead nearly 7 months, his body had been frozen right down to the nerves and had not even begun to decompose. He'd struggled halfway down the cliff path, perhaps looking for some lost goat, or perhaps in a delirium, and expired, curled into a claw right under the winter moon. Even the animals shunned his corpse. The mainlanders thought to bring it home unlucky. Donnelly claims they dragged it to the caves to thaw out and rot. But he is proving an unreliable witness.
Who the hell is Donnelly? You ever do that thing in FPSs where you just kind of turn your head? Even though it's not really going to matter what happens. Just kind of turn your head to see if it can help you aim.
Climbing down to the caves, I slipped and fell and have injured my leg. I think the femur is broken. It is clearly infected. The skin has turned a bright, tight pink, and the pain is crashing in on waves, winter tides against my shoreline, drowning out the ache of my stones. I struggled back to the bothy to rest, but it has become clear that there is only one way this is likely to end. The medical supplies I looted from the trawler have suddenly found their purpose. They will keep me lucid for my final ascent.
Oh. Ah, I get it. I'm gonna die. This is my last dying... This isn't even the caves, this is just a crevice. Clearly, this is where it wants me to go. Down, down we go. Okay, that Duh. Guess I'm going down to the caves.